when Sara and I started to tour, we used to come to Ontario actually quite a bit because there were so many places we could go play. So we used to spend a lot of time in Kingston and Kitchener-Waterloo and in Guelph. And I always had, I felt like Guelph was always a real treat for some reason. I don't know. Maybe because there was young people here, so people would come to the shows, but you know, back then it wasn't uncommon to show up somewhere and there was like five people there to see us and a lot of people who weren't. And we did a lot of support and a lot of opening and it was tough times. And Sara and I would, we would often, I mean, for years, I mean, I think the first 6-7 years of our career, we had to share a hotel room and it was just, it was like being in some sort of like prison release program or something, you know? Like, just, except instead of like shackles, I just was with Sara. No, she felt the same way. Like it was tough. Like it was, you know, most people, they graduated high school, you go off into the world, you go to college or you get a job or you go backpack around Europe or Asia or something. And we did that, but it was like the Greyhound bus across Canada. And these days, my God, I mean, things have changed so much. I feel like young people now, you know, they live at home longer and they have a cell phone when they're 7 and like, it was just, it's just so different. You know, when we first started, I mean, we didn't have a cell phone, we didn't have a credit card. Do you remember that crazy thing that happened on the Greyhound in Manitoba? Why would you bring that up? That was the end for Greyhound. Okay. It was a horrific thing, but that's, like, now, let's try not to think about that, but let's think about, we would play a show.
I just want to think about it for one more second, which is, because I just want to say, like, I'm not trying to be mean to people now, but, like, we still had to book tickets on the Greyhound after that, you know? Like,
no, we did not. That happened so, so long after we stopped.
No, I mean, like, people, hey, excuse me, I used to take the Greyhound down to upstate New York to see my girlfriend's family all the time. We used to carry her goldfish in a jar, a pickle jar. Anyway, we would play these shows.
Those were the days, you know?
No, we're always like, oh, people on the ground are so scary. You're one of them. But one time, our bass player. One time, our bass player. He's not in the band anymore. Not because of this, but just he was on the Greyhound, and he had an itchy spot on his leg afterwards, and it got bigger and bigger and bigger, and it became like a sort of like. Bulb almost, and then white bugs came out of it.
So we used to tour around Ontario and play shows a lot, and we would play the show, and then we would have to sell our merchandise, and then we would go to like an Econo Lodge or you know some sort of like Travelers Inn, and we would kind of shower and reorganize ourselves, and then Sara and I would go together.
Check for bulbs.
Yeah. Often check for bugs. But then we would go and we would deposit our whatever we were paid that night or made in merch. We'd go to like a Royal Bank at like midnight and we would put the money in the bank machine. Don't forget, we're like 18 or 19 years old. And then we would go to the train or the bus station and we would, you know, catch an overnight bus to the next place or whatever. And Sara and I would take turns like while we were waiting for the bus, we would like sit on top of, we used to travel with hockey bags, and we put two guitars in one hockey bag, and then we put our merch and CDs in the other. And we would wear like big, it was like we were traveling in Europe, but we were just in Ontario going between small towns. And we had like big backpacks, and we would carry the hockey bags in between us. And it sucked. But like, and I can remember having conversations. Like, I remember my mom came out for a couple of shows where we were doing a very similar kind of thing. And we drove back to Calgary one night and got in at like 3 a.m. And she had downsized because we'd moved out and I was sharing a bed with her. And we were kind of like getting settled in the dark and I could tell we were like just laying there awake. And my mom just out loud said like, your job is horrible. And like, I remember so many people not understanding why we did what we did. Like no one could understand. It just took one visit. And people would be like, why? But there was just something about standing on stage and playing music. It just somehow would wipe away the shittiness of every day, you know? And that's, I know that sounds so trite and it's such a cliche, but it is clearly what drives
What if it
us.
Wasn't though? What if I actually didn't care about that and I was just like, I'm into the utter chaos and the potential for violence. Like, what if I just was like, it turns out all this time I was just sick, you know? Like, just, I actually got nothing from this and it was just the adrenaline from like the possibility of something just totally awful happening. That, there's that, but also thank you so much for the validation, my friend. It's very different than what Tegan said, that's true.
I didn't get what.
Well, we can have different motivations.
Like, oh yeah, no, we can absolutely. I was just leading to. Sorry, I was just trying to bungee jump out of the story. And I was going to say that, but the thing for me was, you know, getting, especially during these days where it was just the two of us playing, is that, you know, I would get to like hear Sara play songs that I really loved, and I would think like, this is so cool. Like, we're in a band. I don't know. We grew up in the '90s, right? Everybody wanted to be in a band, and I was like, we're doing it, even when it was like so clear. To a lot of people, we were not doing it, you know? But for me, I was like, we're doing it, it's gonna happen. And anyway, this is a Sara song, if it was you, but she said I could cover it and then admitted she just doesn't like it, and so that's probably why. But I like it.
Signs all along. Tell me, where have they gone? Did you take them?